Hi, everybody. It's been a long time since I've been on. I apologize. I'm going to go get my hair dyed in a few weeks. I can't wait. I'm not going to tell anybody what it looks like. Only a few select people know what I'm getting done. So I'm going to do an update video because I think I've done a video for my bullet journal journey, basically. I did a couple updates. So this is going towards the end of the year now. Been doing pretty good. I am going to buy another bullet journal. I do have a few on Amazon on my wish list that I'm like kind of contemplating on which ones I want to get. So, but I really, really like it. Like the one I got is a Panda Natura. That's what I got. And I think it's on, I think I still have the info on the back too. Let me see. Yeah, it is A5 dot matrix journal. Matrix journal light green. That's the one I got. Really loving it. So this is how thick it is right now. I don't use this very much, so even if the next one I have doesn't have this, it doesn't matter. This thing here, it's already come apart. Like basically it just comes right out, but I kind of shove it right frickin' in there so it won't be able to come out. That's the only thing I didn't like is this. Oh, there we go. See, it came apart. So it doesn't matter if it doesn't have one. I'm okay with that because I use bookmarks too. I think I have one here somewhere. I got like a tarot card kind of bookmark. Yeah, so this is kind of how I did mine. So it has this on it. Probably you've seen it before. So probably haven't seen it in a while. So this is what I've done on the first kind of basically page. It says the witch's calendar, and I put all the Sabbats on there, as well as I put, you know, my name and the year as well. If you notice, if I want it on a bookshelf or something, if I'm having it like this, why is it like that? Oh, the year is 2020. So if I ended up buying a few of the same color, at least I knew what year this was. So that's how I started off, with year at a glance. With my new one, I'm also going to do that. I really like this, so I'm going to stick to it for the next time I do it. Same with these. That is the lunar phase calendar, so I'm going to stick with that as well. I tried two. So the index, the only thing I suggest is I didn't leave enough room, and I ran out of room. I ran out of room in August, so I think I need to have two of these, like, going on, like that. And then I created that birthday tracker, which I am going to do again. I loved it. Savings, so I have, like, little envelopes. I have... won't be doing this again because I really didn't like it. The numbers are already in there, and I didn't really like that. So what I'm going to use is, I have a new one I've done. Let me see where it is. It is right there. It's a savings tracker. So basically, I go on girls weekends, and that's what I've been doing. And this one, I actually put it in. It goes up by 10 bucks, and this one's going up by 5 to see which one I like better. I like the $5 one better. So that's one thing I will change for the new one. I did a 2020 reading challenge. I'm still continuing on. I do have currently, I'm at number countdown. I've counted down. The next time I'm going to do this is I'm going to start at 1 and work my way back. I'm working backwards, so until I hit 1. So I'm at 34, but it's actually not 34. I've read... it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 books that I have read. There was a lull there that I didn't read any books for a while. But right now I have, it's called The Unicorn Shop or something like that. I have that one on the go. So that will be number 20. I have... the one by Stephanie Myers, the Twilight series. I have the last one on my thing, so that's like number 21. And then I'm reading another one on my Kindle. So I have one on Audible, two on Audible, actually. Yep. I have two on Audible that I'm reading at the current moment. I have one that's an actual paperback that I'm reading, as well as I have one on Kindle, two actually on Kindle that I'm reading. The one that I'm reading for book club is called The Bone Witch. It's actually really good. So I really like this, and I will continue it next year, with this. I might put actually like books going along it. I haven't decided, like a bookshelf or something. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. So that's a go for next year. So the first six part of the first 6 months of the year, I tried one tracker. So it's like your period and your moon sign tracker. So I did it like this. Okay. I liked it. I did it like that. So I have the moon tracker here and I have the period here. I really like that. Here's the moon phases. I'm gonna stick to this one because right now I have one for the last 6 months of the year and it does one of these. So it's basically it has like your mood and weather tracker and your period tracker all in one. So basically one line would be your like period tracker, the next line would be the mood, and then you would write down kind of like I, E or T. So T for tired, I for irritated, E for energetic. I really don't like this one. So I'm gonna stick with the first one that I did because I really liked doing these. I'll show you once I get to one. I really like doing these, the mood and weather trackers. So each month I had like a different one. So that was an umbrella in May because like I could be more creative, and that was May. You know what I mean? So I think I'm gonna stick to the individual mood and weather tracker by itself, as well as I've done the mini goals all through the year, and I love it. I'll show you. And I've taken away some, added some, so I've really stuck with it. Really stuck with it. The one thing I did add, and I don't know if I'll keep continuing to do it, is I don't think I do it for every month, but I did. Let me see where it is. So I did like a trip and then I had like a Polaroid. So let me see. All right, so this is kind of like we went to a Piper's family vacation, the annual one. It was our first annual, so that is the place we stayed in. And then I kind of basically did who was there, when we went, what the address was, who all came, and kind of like a little rundown of the Piper's family vacation. So I think I'm going to continue that next year and put photos there, as well as I have. I don't know if I'm going to have room to do it. I'm going to have to count how many pages I had extra. So what I did is I put COVID-19 feelings, thoughts, and what the fucks is what I did. So basically, let me see. I talked about like your emotions during this time, like what the heck was going on, like different things like the hoarding of the toilet paper, the Lysol wipes, you know, just for future. And then thoughts on different things we wanted to try and some historical moments that are going to be historical and stuff and things that are changing in our world. So I wrote that. And then have some kind of like little receipts and stuff, things that were going on. I have my ascendant rising sign, so I'm not going to do it for the next one, obviously. I have my Hocus Pocus book club stuff here. I might lessen the pages in it because I really didn't use those pages. I have a Christmas bucket list and an autumn bucket list. What I might do next year is actually half the page. So instead of having two full pages, it'll be half a page each. I have like Polaroid sections for pictures. Same with the Christmas. I have like Christmas lists. Can't really show it in case anybody watches that. I have a memorial page for my best friend. So I've really continued on doing this. So I do my whole calendar for the month, okay? And what I did was monthly tasks and then YouTube video ideas, which I should continue to do this because I don't use it very often. I've decided to start recording my steps. I have holidays in here. I have a sleep tracker that I have on my Fitbit. I have the sleep tracker in there, so I'm going to continue with that. Also, I order from a place called Mystic Dragon's Lair, where I get my crystals and stuff. So I have a lot of invoices and stuff. So I write them at the top of each page of, like, when I know I've ordered it, and I kind of move it along as I'm waiting for shipments to come in. So what I started doing is at the end of each week, I have a box left over. So what I've decided to do is put a Grateful Four. So basically one is like, I do Sopology, which is like a tea, a loose leaf tea. So I like put Sopology clients for my health and for my family. Like I might have one that says, let me see. Being healthy, Etsy order, like if someone ordered Etsy, grateful for new fridge, spending time with fam, seeing my grandson, things like that, you know. Let me see if I had. And then, yeah, so that's kind of like what I've been continuing to do that. Like, I really like doing that. So I've basically, the last probably 3 months, I've used this basically like it should have been, right? I wasn't writing everything I was doing. I basically like use it as a calendar, which is what it's for. But I started doing things like went to look at kitties, you know, did this today or did that, went for ice cream, you know, stuff like that. Just that way when I'm looking back going, oh my God, yeah, I remember that day. I did this, this, and this, right? You know, it was a big, huge thunderstorm. I actually put it in there. I'm like, big, huge thunderstorm tonight. So like, yeah, you can basically see it's been like kind of like a journal. And if I wanted to have more in-depth, then I use my actual journal that I have here, which I actually put pictures and stuff in. I always kind of like put pictures and stuff in here. Let me see if I have other ones. Yeah, I put pictures, my card readings, all that kind of stuff in that one. So that's banalu. So I use it more for that. Let me see what else. I've used stickers. I don't think I should buy that many next year. Like, I'm gonna tell you that right now. I didn't use as many as I thought I was going to. Like, I went freaking hog wild on buying stickers, okay, guys? I have habit trackers. I stopped using it after a while. The ones I did use, if they're called essentials, but it's called monthly planner stickers. So you have weekly, you have moms, but I got the monthly ones, which basically gives you, so it will give you like the month, you know what I mean? It has like little pictures and stuff. So each one will have it. I'm going to reorder this because it is an awesome thing for my calendar, and I really like this, as well as I'm going to probably order the weekly planner stickers. I'm not sure. I'm trying to see which one I've used most of. Like, I don't have to. This one has a lot of book club ones, so I might choose one of these to order, but I probably don't need them all. Like, literally, there's still so much in here. So I think for the following year, I'm just going to stick with the monthly planner stickers is what I'm going to buy for it, because the rest, I'm still good. So let's see. We are in September. So I'm all caught up. I've been doing this on, sometimes if I forget, then I do it a few days. But lately, I've been doing like every single night, I'll do this. So I color coordinate. So there is October is here. So what I did is I outlined it in red and then colored it in orange on the tops there. And then I have like October, and then it has on the bottom, I actually got stickers and I put that there, and it says boo on it. And then here it's all black with orange lettering, which I'm going to stick to this. I love this idea, so I'm going to stick to it. And I've actually numbered the weeks like week 41, because when you use the index, you can put week 41. I think that's how I did it. Let me see. Yeah. So it's like, let's say 59 to page 59 to 60, it's April, May, week 18. So it kind of like gives you a rundown. I put Mercury retrogrades in there. Let me see. I'm trying to see what else. Oh, I'm going on another girls weekend, like right there. So I've kind of like, this is like a ghost hunt. We're hoping that we'll have some actually, you know, items that we can use. So I kind of put some stuff that I wanted to visit there. So we're there all weekend instead of just one night. So I'm really excited about that. So I had one, after everything, I had one page left out of my book, which was awesome. So I think I'm going to count out the pages I didn't use in the middle and see if I have enough to do what I actually want to do for next year. Then I put a 2020 bucket list right here. This was before COVID hit. So now everything's on hold. And then on the back, I put a divination and spiritual goals. So I kind of created that. On there, there's a pocket here. Right there. So it's awesome. But that is my update for bullet journals. And yes, I am going to use mine again. I'm going to purchase one again. If you like these types of videos, you'd like to see more in the new year, or how I'm planning to plan my next one, which will probably be in the month of October or November. Not sure. I started this one right after Christmas, so I want to start it earlier. So let me know if you'd like to see more videos on this. You guys have an amazing night. Bye-bye.